The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. As you can see, we're here on Mr. Horse. Last time we picked up Mr. Horse, and by the way, I'd like to say this horse looks really beautiful as well. Like sometimes horses can look a little bit derpy in games and things, but I think they've done a magnificent job. It looks really nice. I like the way that the mane just kind of flutters in the wind and stuff. That's so cool. Plus, we can make him dance. Look. There we go. Dance, Mr. Horse, dance. Which is pretty cool. So it's holding like ZL, I think it is. And we can do that. There we go. We can also go backwards in him as well. We can reverse. Which is pretty cool. So, what are we going to do today? Well, as much as I kind of like hanging around this stable and it's really nice. It's about time we moved on, isn't it? So we have to go and seek out Impa, which means we're going to have to head up this road here, across this bridge, around here, Bonaruro stand, and to this village up here. We also learned, I think there's a village down here somewhere. I think they were saying it could be off this map, could be here, but yeah, so let's do that, I guess. I haven't decided what speed I want. I think this is good. Elephant birds. As we go through. So it's kind of cool to have a horse. But I know that, like, I think the horse can die. So, or at least get scared away. So we have to be careful as well. With what we're doing. Another guy on a horse. You've got a nice horse, a spotted horse. Whoa. There we go. Okay, so we've got some thing there. I just wanted to have a look at the little sign down here and see what it says. Oh, I also found out that if you hold jump, he will jump off, and then if you use the arrow, it slows down time. That's super cool. I would definitely be trying that out. Okay. Kariko Village. Oh, Hatano Village. Okay, cool. So they were speaking about Hatano Village. So Hatano Village is actually up this way. But we want to go this way. It's beautifully animated as well, I must say. Like, I know people are going on about how good this game looks, but... it kind of reminds me a little bit of Shadow of the Colossus, if that makes sense, because Shadow of the Colossus is a game which was very beautiful at the time without being like, kind of like the art style and everything still holds up nowadays, and I think this is definitely going to be one of those games where, even though technologically in the future we will advance a lot further, let's see, I could do with getting some of these plants, so I guess I will. Yeah, even though we would have advanced in the future a lot in terms of graphical power and stuff like that, I think art style is something which lasts forever, you know? Which is why something like Hearthstone doesn't seem like it ages, you know? Because, and you know, something like Shadow of the Colossus still looks good nowadays. And why I was playing Theme Hospital the other day, and I was like, you know what, this game still looks okay, considering it's 20 years old. Let's use my one of my bombs. That doesn't like the skin horse, does it? It doesn't, no. Because we want some rock salt. We'll take that. And I guess we'll do this again here. I like the fact that you have the square bombs and the white bombs. That's super cool. We've got a bit of amber here. What's this? Amaranth. The tough medicinal block can be broken, but if it's cooked, it's durable. Yeah, flexible fried is raised in defense when cooked into a dish. Okay, that's interesting. I thought what I wanted was a bit... Oh, no, it's there. Amber. Good stuff. So, I actually had a thought when I sold that, like, stuff. I was like, oh, you know what? I don't know if I need it for anything yet, so I don't know if I want to sell it, because it's not like I need the money for anything, so I generally don't know if I need it for anything, so I'm not going to sell anything else. I think the little icons there denote like how fast you're going, so I can go a lot faster than this, but seeing as we're going into unknown territory, probably would be best if I don't do that just yet, you know. Okay, what's that? That looks like a big... It's a guy with a satchel, that's for sure. Let's kind of trot up here. I don't think he looks like he's going to be attacking me. And I guess we're going to have a chat, aren't we? Shalaka. Shalaka. You. You can see me. I can see you, yeah. Shalakan. It's been 100 years since anyone's been able to see me. I'm Estu. I need your help. Those monsters over there stole my beloved Maracas. What? That's outrageous. I think they're still on the other side of those rocks. Oh dear, I can't use my powers without them. Shoko, so please, please get my Maracas back from them. Oh, I mean, you know, the priceless Maracas. Like, don't worry about it, buddy. Okay, get your Maracas. Monster killing is my forte. Okay, Mr. Horse. Just wait there for a moment. Gonna go scope this out, I think. You know, what we're probably best off doing is climbing up here. Oh, can we not climb it? Yeah, of course we can climb it. Of course we can climb. How dare I even think that we couldn't? How dare I even suggest that I wouldn't be able to climb something? Okay. Get a bit of an aerial view. What's going on here? They look like they're all asleep. Which is kind of fine by me. Okay, there's like three of these guys. Too many of those, we've got enough of these arrows to make light work of these guys, I think. We don't need the arrows now, we could probably just... Whoa, that hurt. That was a little bit slack of me there. Let's just eat something. Sure, the simmered fruit. Let's go. Oh, I set my weapon on fire. Whoops. I set my boomerang on fire. I didn't want to do that. Can we... Okay, I think I might put it out. I hope so anyway. See if these Maracas are here. Estu's Maracas. Estu's beloved Maracas. He's been shaking them since he was 2 years old. Well, no problem, Estu. By the way, this is pretty cool around here. Wow. Whoa. I didn't realize I was walking to the edge there. Is that a shrine over there? It is a shrine. A bit, thank you. Okay. Where is Estu? There he is. Let's get on Mr. Horse again. Shalalaka. But wait, there's something wrong with my... Oh, of course there is. The crocker seats inside them are gone. How am I supposed to dance now? Short call. If I just had one crocker seat, I could sync dance, use my powers to help you. You see, I have the power of infantry expansion. Select the power of infantry expansion. I'm sorry. When was that a power? Hey, can we get a roll call on the superheroes, please? Okay, we got Superman. We got Batman. We got infantry expansion, man. Like, what the hell? Okay, well, look, I've got loads of Korok seeds, so. But wait, Sniff Sniff, do you have Korok seed? Yes, I do. Got a Korok seed for one of the forest children. If you give me just one Korok seed, I'll make you a bigger return. Yes, please. Oh shit, I pressed no. I pressed the wrong button. There you go. Shalaka. So, which stash do you want more slots in? Oh, okay. Weapon. Yep. Oh yeah. Shaki Shalaka. Oh yeah. Oh, you've got the moves there. That's awesome. That is truly awesome. Da 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 da. Your weapons are... I still smell Korok seeds on you, do you really? Okay, well, we'll get another one in weapon because it's, I think that's really useful. Then we'll go for bow. We've got loads, actually. Oh, yeah. Shaki shaka. I'm not even gonna skip this, it's too good. That is incredible. That is incredible. Oh my god, I've actually got like tears in my eyes. Oh, look at the time, I need to get back before Grandpa yells at me. Hey, what? To Korok Forest if you find any. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Wait, can I not just. Bring my Maracas back once I see you off. I'm going back home to Korok Forest. Did you want? Where's Korok Forest? Yeah, it should be somewhere north of here. Grandpa told me if you get lost, follow the Hylia River and continue north. That's what he said. Grandpa is no liar. Do you want to talk some more? Yeah, who are you? Huh? I suppose I should tell you a little something about myself. My name is Estu, the most celebrated musician of Korok Forest. Shalakala. Do you want to talk some more? I know what Korok seeds are, so no, you're good, buddy. Okay, so, that was that shrine we saw. He said head north to Korok Forest. Oh, bloody hell, where the hell? Okay, well, that was a nice little side quest there, which genuinely made me laugh a lot. Shame we couldn't have expanded a little bit more, but it's good to get more weapons though. In actual fact, no, we're fine with what we've got in a minute. Who's this guy? Hope he gives a challenge on rainy day. Okay, I'll take a look. Oh, an energetic rhino beetle. Nah. I'll take the fish. Wow, that was 72. I didn't realise that was that much. How much can I sell? Acorns don't give me a lot. Oh, I could definitely sell some of these. Sell like 20 of them. Here we go. Made our money back anyway. Almost. There we go. Thanks. Thank you very much, sir. I will take care of that. Also, you can admire my beautiful horse if you wish. I don't think you like the horse. Okay. Is this even the, by the way, is this the right, yeah, it is the right way, okay. God, I keep accidentally thrashing the horse. I saw some stamina mushrooms there. I'll definitely take those then. Oh, hello. That's good. Oh, there's a block here. God, no, that's the one. This has got to be a Korok, isn't it? Looks like we're coming up into something. I wonder what this is. Okay, this is the village. Kakariko village. Wow. That's very beautiful. Let's just have a chat with you. Traveller, I'm sorry, but I seem to have twisted my ankle. Oh dear. Let's see here. Sorry, you had to see me like that. That's all right. Say, traveller. Where did you get that object hanging from your waist? Well, you see. I guess Link's explaining now how it all happened. Yes, I see. That Sheikah's Link is a symbol. It means you are the hero of legend. Though there are few who know of such legends anymore. But we Sheikah have been waiting for you for a very long time. Please, before or else, I must insist you meet with our leader, Lady Impa. Okay, where is she? Okay, she's in the big house. Gotta guess that. Below Lantern Falls. Oh, wow, yeah, look at Lantern Falls. Just over there. In any case, it was a real honour to meet you. Eh, I suppose you're used to that. Having lived as long as you have. I guess so. We didn't really want the tree branch, did we? But never mind, I guess it'll make a good thing for fire at least. Okay, yeah, I actually wanted to get my horse, so, yeah, thanks. Thanks, yeah, can I? Thank you. We'll just trot around here because I don't really know the landscape. I guess we'll go I'll go straight to the house and then we'll explore the little village afterwards. It is night time anyway, so there might not be as many people around as there would be normally. Okay. Just park up the horse. Hey there, guys. You there, who are you? How dare you trespass upon Lady Impus? I haven't even got on her house yet. Is that a Sheikah slate? But that would mean you are. No, it's not possible. Can it be? Yeah, it is. Yep. Yeah. That's right. You better show me some respect. Please forgive us for behaving so rudely. You're forgiven for now. Of course, we have heard the legends from Lady Impa herself. Please, friend, go ahead and step inside. Okay. Dorian. Enough of your cheek, you and Caddo. A man. Kind of a boy actually, but there you go. Is that? It's a Sheikah. Jesus, these people and their Sheikah slate obsession. Could you be the hero my grandmother told me about? What was his name? Ling. It's not that I forgot. It's just I'm bad at speaking. As for me, my name is Papa Peya. Oh, my name is Peya. Okay, Peya. Phew, I got it out. I know I should be able to say that easily, seeing as how it's my own name and all. I'm so sorry. Anyway, my grandmother's been awaiting your return ever since I was little. Please hurry inside. Okay.
So, you're finally awake.
Yes.
Much older now.
What is the matter? You look at me as though I'm a stranger to use those eyes. They lack the light of familiarity. It is a courageous one, Impa. Surely you remember the name, Impa. I see, so you have lost your memory. Well, it matters not. In fact, that may actually be a blessing in disguise for the time being. Dearest Link, please come a bit closer. Yes, 100 years ago, the Kingdom of Hyrule was destroyed. After you fell, Princess Zelda's final wish was to place you in a sacred slumber. And then, all alone, she went to face Ganon. Before Princess Zelda went to nobly meet her fate, she entrusted me with some words she wished to say to you. I've been waiting 100 years to deliver the princess's message. However, these words which the princess risked her life to leave you, well, if you are to hear them, must be prepared to risk your life as well. But I'm afraid that burden may be too much to bear while you're still without your memories. I leave the choice to you. When you feel you're ready to receive the princess's message, return to me. Well, what does that mean? The words the princess risked her life to impart you, I cannot pass them on to someone who lacks conviction. Are you prepared to risk your life for greater good? Sure, yeah. Ah. Not a memory to your name, yet you are as intent as ever to charge forward with only courage and justice on your side. You have changed a bit to once hero, always a hero. Very well. Since you have lost your memory, I will recount for you all that has happened.
The history of the royal family of Hyrule is also the history of Calamity Ganon, a primal evil that has endured over the ages. This evil has been turned back time and time again by a warrior wielding the soul of a hero and a princess who carries the blood of the goddess. With the passage of time, each conflict with Ganon faded into legend. So listen closely as I tell you of this legend that occurred 10,000 years ago. Hyrule was then blossoming as a highly advanced civilization. Even the most powerful monsters posed little threat to the denizens of the realm. The people thought it wise to utilize their technological prowess to ensure the safety of the land should Calamity Ganon ever return. They constructed 4 mechanical wonders that came to be known as the Divine Beasts. They also built a legion of autonomous weapons called Guardians. The Divine Beasts were piloted by 4 individuals of exceptional skill from across the land, and thus the plan to neutralize Ganon was forged. Upon Ganon's inevitable return to Hyrule, the princess and the hero fought alongside these 4 champions against this ancient evil. The guardians were tasked with protecting the hero as the divine beasts unleashed a furious attack upon their terrible foe. And when the hero, wielding the sword that seals the darkness, delivered his final blow, the princess used her sacred power to seal away Calamity Ganon.
100 years ago, in preparation for the foretold revival of canon, we strove to follow the lead of our ancestors of 10,000 years prior. But in the end, despite our best efforts and careful planning, we underestimated his power. In order to avoid ever making that mistake again, the priest has left you these words. Free the four divine beasts, that is what she said. The four divine beasts are the ancient Sheikah weapons wielded by the four champions who Galen defeated. Divine beast of Varudania, controlled by Darek of the Gorons. Divine beast of Var Meadow, controlled by Revali of the Rito. Divine beast Ru Varuta, controlled by the Meepa of the Zora. And the divine beast Var Naborus, controlled by Oboso of the Gerudo. Be extremely advised to face Ganon without the power of the divine beast to help you. You must infiltrate the divine beasts that were stolen away by Ganon 100 years ago and bring them back to our side. More information about these divine beasts can be found by locating the four races scattered across Hyrule. Okay, cool. The Sheikah Slate will guide you on your way. You must go where it tells you and meet with each leader there. Okie dokie, right. Seems to me that your Sheikah Slate is not yet complete. Divine Prince has left you as your guide and also your memory. Now let's see. Someone in the research lab in Adeno Village might be able to help you. Okay, I think I know where that is. Yeah. Okay, cool. So I think we're going to go there next. The location shining on the eastern edge is Adeno Village. It is a small village, one of the very few places that avoid suffering significant damage during the Great Calamity. You are Princess Zelda's only hope, and Hyrule's as well. You cannot turn back now. Follow your heart and seize your destiny. Okay, thank you, Impa. Anything else we can talk to you about? Is something wrong? Don't tell me the steel has slipped from your spine. I realize you have just awoken. I am not suggesting you must defeat Calamity Ganon right this moment. For now, you should focus on getting that broken Sheikah Slate fixed. Hurry to the research lab. 1,000 years ago, very well. Since you lost your memory, I'm glad to tell you as many times you need to. Oh dear, no. What? Skip. I don't need to see that again. We've seen that. 100 years ago. Okay. Okay. Understood. Save her and save Hyrule. Okay. Bye. Let's go. Master Link. Whatever is the matter at this hour, dark magic preys upon the land when darkness falls. Please promise to take care. Sure. Okay. She's not going to say. No. Okay. Wow. An amazing little village. Let me just check around this house. And some nice waterfalls as well. Looks nice. No, don't climb the house. They might be angry about this. Chat to these guys, Kato. Recently, the Vika clan has been acting suspiciously. It's our duty to protect Lady Impa. Vika clan. We of the Sheikah tribe have long been heralded as a people of great wisdom. Our technology became the key to sealing Ganon away during the Great Calamity some 10,000 years ago. At one point, our technology was praised as the power of the gods, but eventually, the people turned on us. Our creations came to be viewed as a threat to the kingdom. The Sheikah became outcasts and forced into exile. Some like us chose to cast off our technological advances and strove to live normal lives. Others fostered a hatred towards the kingdom that shunned them. These sad souls swore their allegiance to Ganon. They now call themselves the Yiga clan. Their sole mission is to avoid and eliminate all who stand against Ganon. Please, dear, be careful out there. Okay, I will do. The Yiga clan. I don't feel like I should take any of those apples. I feel instead like I should probably put an apple down there. There we go. What did I say? Your family. Cool. Thank you very much, buddy. You can take my apples back now. Good stuff. Okay, this person's got a little moon on it. Shut eye in. Okay, that's an in. Good name for an in too. That's a high spirits produce. A curious quiver. Let's go in here, shall we? Welcome. Yeah. I can't remember last time we had a customer in here. Young folks in the village don't have much use for a bow. Thrilled to see a light young lad like you come to shop. Well, don't mind me. Take your time looking around. What are you going to sell me? I'm excited to find out. Well, I don't know what I should sell, what I should keep, actually, in all honesty. Mom? Okay, so it looks like we can buy some arrows. So they're normal arrows. They're fire arrows. I actually do want some of those. We'll take... If I take 10, that's 200. So I'll take 5. Okay. Cool. Okay. Okay. Oh, this little cooking thing over here. This little dining area, I guess. Pot lid. Use that as a shield. So, what do I want to... I actually do want to cook up some herbs. Oh shit, sorry. Let's chuck in 3 herbs. No, let's chuck in. Let's chuck in 3 herbs, see what that does. That's just one thing, it should give me like 2 to 3 hearts back. Yeah, see, that's cool. I think that will do for now. Look how happy he is. Look how happy he's cooking. He's found his calling in life to be a chef. Okay. Let's go in here and have a look what you've got. Oh wow, look at this. I got some butter, bird eggs, swift carrots, Bobo King guts. Traveller, welcome to Kikoriko Village. We are blessed with the protection of the goddess. That's why we have so many healthy, happy animals and abundance of fine crops. My products are all locally grown, fresh and seasonal. Truly choice goods. That brings something special to any recipe. Go on, grab one. Are you here for something else? Recommendations. Recommendations, let me think. Well, everything I sell, really. Well, you would say that. But if you want specifics, there's always swift carrots. My mister grows them. They put Kikoriko Village on the map. Actually, to be honest, there's one other crop Kikoriko is known for, fortified pumpkins. I'll see them here, but you see, my mister and the pumpkin farmer, they don't exactly get along. So if you want fortified pumpkins, you have to go straight. You have to get them straight from Olkin's patch. Okay. Stop by any time, thanks. Nah, they're 16. I'm not buying a carrot for 16. Even if it does make me swift. Where the hell's this pumpkin patch then, eh? Let's shut eye in. Let's go in here, even though we don't need to get any shut eye. Hey, are you a good guest? I suppose so. This is going to be after death. Well, the regular bed's 20 rupees, and the soft bed is 40 rupees, I guess. Okay. have conquered the shrines and claimed their orbs in exchange for 4 spirit orbs. Oh, okay, sure. What do I want? More stamina. I want another heart container. Yeah. Yes, I do, please. I shall grant the powers you seek. Now I don't have any spirit orbs. But that's okay. Yeah. Now we have 4 hearts. That's a little bit better, actually. Go bring peace to Hyrule. Thank you, I will. Are you sorry to bother you, but are you a fellow traveller? I am. As it be, I just love art. In fact, I'm travelling the world in search of beautiful landscapes. Between you and me. I hear there's a great fairy fountain somewhere near this village. I hear it's breathtakingly beautiful. Interesting. Aesthetics aside, they also say the place can bestow some kind of mysterious power on people. However, since I'm an outsider, I can't get anyone to tell me any more details than that. These villagers never leave the safety of their village, so travellers like me are treated with suspicion. But I won't give up. Oh, and if I manage to find anything, I'll be sure to let you know. Thanks. I can hear that ringing again. You know what I actually might do now is, put the Sheikah sensor back on. Why can I not seem to put it on? She gets it. Oh, right, okay. Shrine nearby. What do you reckon up there? Hello. New clothes, cute outfits. Enchanted is open for business every day of the year. Oh my, look at that face. You are totally my... Wow, okay. Slightly creepy. Oh, and you even have a Sheikah slate on your hip. Wait. A Sheikah slate. Isn't that like an incredible thing that only incredible people can have? Well, you know, I'm not sure what this all means, mister, but it seems you have a great deal more important than you appear. Thank you. Need some new clothes. I would not mind some new clothes, actually. We got some of those. Ooh, look at this. That looks pretty cool. Okay, we might pick that up. Oh, and a hood. Nice. Oh, welcome to Enchanted, my high-end boutique. By the by, the stealth chest guard over there is highly recommended. While you wear it, your footsteps are nearly soundless, so it's perfect for hunting and stuff. But it offers very little defense, small price for the extra stealth. Okay, interesting. Is this the stealth of the chest? Oh, 700. Wow. Stealth tights. So we've got the trousers. Let's pick up this tunic. Yeah, I'll take it. And then let's take this. And maybe we'll come back for the other stuff. Nice. I'm gonna be funny. Link does look a little bit androgynous right now. I'll examine this. Rumour Mill Volume 1. Who loves gossip more than a solid 3 meals a day? Tracy, of course. Anyone reading this, I'm sure. Today's top gossip spot is the Lover's Pond. Legend says that those who find this pond are sure to also find their true love. Sounds worthwhile to me. Joyce's recommendation, 5 stars. Okay, thanks. Got some new clothes, everybody. That's awesome. Just gonna have a look up here, see if we can find this. I hear a woman cry. Ghosts aren't real. I think there's gotta be a shrine up here. Right, chickadee. There's a shrine up here. Good stuff. Talon Nag shrine. Just have a look here while we're here. Wowzers. another shrine there. But that's not the way we want to go, though. Unfortunately, the way we want to go is this way, to the village. So we will do this shrine, I think, this episode, because these usually don't take too long to do, and then we'll finish up the next episode. I guess we'll head to the Haitano village to get our thingy. Sheikah Slate working again. God, I'm really enjoying this game. It's really good fun. Sometimes the weapons, yep, I know. So we haven't got any more of those spirit orb things, but it was worth it, I think, to get another heart. It just makes us that little bit harder to kill. And we also look a bit more badass now. Except for the shrine, I am Tallow Nig. I share with you my knowledge that it may please Hylia. Something looks suspicious here right now. The shield of the mind's eye, a small sheikah. Wow, that's a good shield. Decrease button without sacrifice. That's a really good shield. Backflip to avoid enemy attacks and create an opening to strike back. Okay. Nice. You can repel an attack if you parry with your shield at the same time. Strike back to an opening. About this. Not very good at it though. Okay. Build up your power and release it to unleash a charged attack. Catch your enemies in this motion to damage them. Another mention though. That'd be awesome. The triumph over the distance drinks up votes. Yep, okay, I hear you. In the name of God is Hylia, I bestow upon you this spirit orb. Thank you very much, buddy. Also, check out my sweet new armor and my hood and cape. That's pretty darn cool. Thank you. May the goddess smile upon you. Oof. I was trying to read that game. Okay, cool. Right, so I think we're going to finish up there. Thank you so much for joining me again on this amazing adventure in this amazing game. And yeah, I guess I'll catch you guys next time. And I guess we'll explore a little bit more of this village. And then I'm tempted to go. How far away is that shrine? Realistically, how far away is it? It's quite far, and we'd have to go off the... Yeah, okay. We'll come back for that shrine another time. But, that's a shrine as well. How far away is that shrine? Okay, that shrine might be doable. Maybe we'll go and see that shrine. But, yeah, thank you so much for watching, as always. It's been my pleasure. I'll catch you guys.